हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड कीप योरसेल्फ बिजी इन स्टडी। स्टूडेंट्स, अब चैप्टर द वैदिक पीरियड, दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। एंड इन द प्रीवियस आई डिस्कस द सोर्सेज ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द वैदिक पीरियड, दैट इज द लिटरेरी एंड द आर्कोलॉजिकल सोर्सेज। इन दिस आई विल टेल अबाउट द features of the early Vedic period and the later Vedic period. First of all, the early Vedic period lies between the time period 1500 BCE to 1000 BCE, and the later Vedic period was from the 1000 BCE to 500 BCE. Students, I will use EVP short form for the early Vedic period and LVP for the later Vedic period. First of all, about the Vedas, you know it very well now, there are the four Vedas. And the first Veda, the Rig Veda, is the oldest Veda and it was composed during the time of the early Vedic period. The rest of the three, that is the Sam Veda, Yajur Veda and the Athar Veda, all of these three were composed during the later Vedic period. Next is about the settlement during the early Vedic period. Firstly, the Aryans were settled in the Saptasindhu region. Saptasindhu means seven rivers region, that is a Punjab. In the Punjab at the time there was the river Indus and its tributaries, and the land of the Punjab was very rich and fertile, and it was referred as a Brahmavarta. Brahmavarta means land of the gods. And during the later Vedic period, Aryans moved towards the eastern side, eastern direction of India, and they settled in the Ganga Yamuna Doab region. Ganga Yamuna means the land between the two rivers of the Ganga Yamuna, that is called the Doab. And this land is called the Aryavarta or the land of the Aryans. Here I have a picture. You can check it in the map. This is a settlement of the Aryans in the early Vedic period. Look at it. It is a area of the Punjab. Some areas cover in the Jammu and Kashmir. And this is the area of the Pakistan, which earlier the part of the Punjab. And it is a Peshawar, Harappa, etc. These sites are here. And it is a river Indus and its tributaries, that is the Jhelum, Chenab, Vis, Sutlej, Ravi, etc. In the later Vedic period, the Aryans moved towards the eastern side and then they settled in the Ganga and Yamuna Doab region. Here it is Ayodhya, Kurukshetra, Indraprastha. Indraprastha means that is today's Delhi. So in these areas, Aryans settled during the later Vedic period. Next is the Vedic society. In the Vedic society, first of all, families there. The families were patriarch. The families were patriarch. Patriarch means head of the family was a oldest male member. The oldest male member was the head of the family, that is called the patriarch system was there. The oldest male member was the head of the family and he was called the Grihapati. He was called Grihapati. Joint family system was there. Monogamy was practiced. Monogamy means one man had one wife. And polygamy was among the royal and noble families. Royal means jo king families hai, ministers ki family hai. They had the polygamy system, means they could had more than one wife. And then wife was responsible for the household work. So this is the system of the family. It was same during the early Vedic age and the later Vedic age. Position of woman in the early Vedic age, it was very respectful position of the woman during the early Vedic period. Woman had right to education. They enjoyed equal opportunities as men. they can attend the assemblies. There were two type of assemblies, sabha and smiti. Later on I will discuss it with you in the next video. Child marries, sati system was absent, means at that time child marries, sati system was not there. Next is, the woman could remarry and could choose their husband. The woman had the right to remarry, and they can, means after the death of their husband, they can remarry, and they had the right to choose their husband. So this is about the position of women during the early Vedic period. In the later Vedic period, there was a decline in the status of women. Now woman position was not good. It was totally declined. Women did not have right to property. Child marriage took place. Women not allowed to attend the assemblies and not allowed to study the Vedas. Means they even not had the right to education. So in this way, the woman position was totally declined during the later Vedic period. This is the most important difference of the early Vedic age and the later Vedic age about the position of the woman. During the early Vedic age, the position of women was very good, but not during the time of the later Vedic period. Next is about the food, dress and amusements. Men and women wore cotton and woolen clothes. Among the ornaments, they wore the ornaments made up of the gold, silver and ivory, and both men and women wore the ornaments. Under the food items, barley, milk products, vegetables, fruits were their main food items. For the recreation or for the amusements, chariot racing means rath vagara hote hain, unse jo race lagate hain ye. Chariot racing, horse racing, dice playing like chess, music and dance were the part of their entertainment, part of their recreation. During the later Vedic period, we have the evidences of rice production. Dekho, first of all, there was in the early Vedic age, barley was there. In the later Vedic period, rice production was also there. And drinks, soma and sura, two types of drinks are there, soma and sura, which were the intoxicating drinks. And they were used to drink during the time of the festivals. Next is about the social divisions. During the early Vedic period, the society was divided into four classes on the basis of occupation. देखो तो occupation के ऊपर base पर कि जो person जिस job में efficient है, जिस job में skilled है, ठीक है, जिस job में जो person perfect है, the man woman got the same job, got the same work. तो उस basis पर classes को divide किया गया था. The society was divided. First of all, there was the Brahmins. Brahmins were the scholars, learned men who explained the Vedic text and performed the religious ceremonies. Second is the Kshatriyas. Kshatriyas, they belong to the ruling class. So, ruling class means the warriors who protect the tribe from the enemies, from the outside attacks. Vaishyas, they engaged in trade, agriculture and industrial activities, means they were the like business holders were there. Shudras, who served the other three classes, who were the unskilled, means they were the carpenters, cobblers, like these persons were there in the Shudras, and they served the other three classes. And this system was not hereditary. This system was not hereditary. It was not rigid. तो ये नहीं था उस टाइम पर कि वैश्य का बेटा वैश्य ही बनेगा, शूद्र का बेटा शूद्र ही बनेगा, क्षत्रिय का बेटा क्षत्रिय होगा. नो, इट वॉज नॉट सो. इन द अर्ली वैदिक पीरियड, इट वॉज डिवाइडेड ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द ऑक्यूपेशन. देखो, अगर वैश्य का बेटा है या बेटी है, सन नो डॉटर, ओके, विच एवर इज देयर, इफ दे आर इंटरेस्टेड, दे आर इन द एजुकेशन एंड दे बिकम द स्कॉलर्स, देन दे कैन इवन ऑक्युपाइड द ऑक्युपेशन ऑफ अ ब्राह्मीन. If the Brahmin son is not a scholar, daughter not a scholar, they can go the position of the Shudras. So in this way, it was not hereditary in the early Vedic age, but in the later Vedic age, it became hereditary. Shudras son became Shudras, Vaishya son became Vaishyas. Caste system prevalent there. Caste system aage thi ab. The social division became rigid. superior position were enjoyed by Brahmins and Kshatriyas. So Brahmins and Kshatriyas, they considered the upper class, and the Shudras became the lower class, and they came to be regarded as the untouchables. So Shudras came to be regarded as the untouchables. They are regarded as untouchables. So in this way, the society was totally different society in the later Vedic age. Next is the four ashrams or stages of life. The life of a man was divided into four stages. They were the brahmacharya, grihastha, vanaprastha and the sannyasa. In the brahmacharya, it is up to 25 years of age. It was the time to acquire knowledge. Brahmacharya, man, woman, they go to the gurukul. They go to the gurukul to acquire the knowledge, to learn something from their guru, to take the education. And the about the gurukul system, I will tell you it in detail in the next video. Grihastha, it is from the 25 years to 50 years when man got married and led the family life. So he or she, man got married and they enjoyed the married life in the grihastha. Third is the vanaprastha. It was from the 50 to 75 years when man handed over his property and responsibilities to his sons. So apne beto ko de raha hai property and responsibility, handed over to their sons. I retired to the forest, and he went to the forest and practiced meditation there. So wahan pe meditation practice ho rahi hai in the vanaprastha. Sannyasa, it is from the 75 years onwards when man had to renounce all worldly pleasures. Renounce all worldly pleasures, sab kuch chhod diya hai, family ko, no one come to meet him in the forest. The man believed he could get moksha. Moksha means freedom from the cycle of life and death. The man believed he could get moksha or salvation by renunciation. Renunciation means renounce all the worldly pleasures. So in this way, these are the four ashrams in which the life of a man was divided, that is the brahmacharya, grihastha, vanaprastha and the sannyasa. Students, it is all about today. Next topics, that is the religion, economy, then gurukul system, political organization, in the next video I will discuss, and that will be the last video of this chapter. In today's video, I discuss with you about the early Vedic A period and the later Vedic period, the various features of these two periods, that is the Vedas settlement, during this period where the Aryans were settled, about the Vedic society. In the Vedic society, I tell you about the family system, about the position of women in the early Vedic period and the later Vedic period, then the food, dress and amusements, then social divisions. There were the four social divisions: Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and the Shudras. And then about the four ashrams or stages of life, that is the Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and the Sannyasa. Students, it is all about today. Have a nice day. God bless you.